Hello and welcome back to this course. This is the last video about the exception handling, in which we learn about the checked exception. In our previous videos, we have discussed about the unchecked exception. Basically, we got the unchecked exception at the runtime and the checked exception appears at the compile time. For example, in the checked exception, we have the IO exception, we have SQL exception and many other exceptions like that. These are the classes that are the checked exceptions. Now, when sometime you write your code, you will get the compile time error that this thing may contains the exception. So you have to type the try catch block, or you have to tell Java that Java has to handle this exception. For example, I type here, we know that we can also throw the exception. So I type here throw new IO exception like this. Now we have to import the IO exception. It is present in the IO package, which is the IO exception class in this way. And now you can see the error. Unreported exception IO exception must be caught or declared to be thrown. Now if I run this program, you will see the, I click on anyway, you can see exception in the thread main. Java.io exception must be caught or declared to be thrown at exception handling. It means that we have to write our own try catch block, or we have to tell Java that you have to handle this exception. Now, how we can tell the Java to handle this exception? We are going to use the throws keyword. This is the throw keyword, and if we want to tell Java that you have to handle this exception, then we use the throws keyword. Now we write throws after the name of the method in which we have written that code. In this case, we have written the code in the main method. So I type here throws, and I type here IO exception like this. And now you can see that error has gone, because now we have tell Java that you have to handle this IO exception. We have throws the IO exception. But now the default cache mechanism of Java is used, and our program is going to exit if IO exception occurs. So by using the throws, we are just removing the compile time error. But to make our application robust, we must have to use our own try catch block. We can also use the throws keyword to tell Java that you have to handle this exception. But the best programming approach that we have to write our own try catch block. So I remove this from here and I type my own try catch. I type here try, and I type this line in this try block like this. And after that I type here catch, and I want to catch the IO exception. So I type here IO exception E and system.out.println, and I type here e.get message like this. Okay. So also in this way, we can handle the checked exception by using the try catch block, or if you don't want to use the try catch block, you can simply throws that exception. Like I type here throws and then IO exception like this. This is also a way to remove the compile time exception error. So I hope that you understand that how we can use the try, how we can use the catch, finally throw and throws keyword. These are the keywords that are used in the exception handling. So in this way, we can handle our exceptions in the Java programming. I hope you understand. Now one more thing that you have to keep in your mind, that here we are using the throws IO exception. This is the checked exception. We are getting the exception error at the compile time. And in the unchecked exception, we are getting the exception error at the runtime. So this is the difference between the checked and the unchecked exception. There the compiler does not check for the exception. The exception occurs at the runtime. But here the compiler check for the exception, and we have to handle that exception before running that program at the compile time. It is not compulsory that the exception always occur in the checked exception, but the compiler thinks that the exception may occur in this line. So that's why we have to handle that through the exception handling, and we use our own try catch or throws to handle the checked exception. I hope that you understand. Anyhow, if you feel any problem while understanding any topic in the exception handling, you can definitely ask me a question or message me. I am always here to help you. So I hope you understand. That's it for this video. I will see you in next video.